I grew up in East Texas, born and raised. I've lived here for the last 52 years on the banks of the lake. As a kid, I just thought it was a place to hunt and fish. It was just a tool to use. It was my backyard. It's where I grew up and I played. As I got older, I started to appreciate the birds, the fish, the different animals that make up this ecosystem, and the rises and falls of water. I started to realize what was happening when we got droughts, when we got floods, and how it all worked together to create this ecosystem. Nature needs certain times a year, certain flows, sometimes high water, sometimes low water, to disperse seeds, to trigger fish to spawn. In the 1940s, there were quite a few devastating floods in and around Texas, so there was a lot of dam building that went on in the 50s. There are three primary tributaries to Caddo Lake. Big Cypress is the biggest one and was one of the areas that was impounded to control some dangerous flooding, but they operated it so they would keep a steady level at Caddo.
It wasn't immediately obvious what was going on, but over time there was a lot of die-off of trees. Fish that were here disappeared. Wetlands were no longer connected to one another. The overall system just wasn't functioning. It's not practical to remove this dam. There would be too much damage to historic towns and population centers, but by tweaking the way they're operated, we can make sure we're balancing the needs of nature with the needs of people. If we can try to recreate Mother Nature within the limits of the dam, what would that look like? What would it take to keep the forest healthy, to try and see more of these specialized fish that should be here, to get them back?
In this case, we're using the dam more as a tool to put some degree of function back in place. The Corps of Engineers staff took a look at how they operate the dam and looked at our flow recommendations. They adopted a change to work in these flows.
What we're seeing out here may not look like much, but this is actually the result of what the Corps of Engineers releasing our prescriptions looks like. This is like a doctor prescribing just what the patient needs. And this is what the river needs.
Not only has the Corps been releasing these flows, but we've actually put in place the science to see if the ecosystem is responding to that. With even some small changes to how the flows are released, we've seen the systems bounce back.
The fish community is already beginning to respond to the flows. Some of these ones that we call fluvial specialists, that like the faster moving water like this, we're seeing their numbers go up. These are some of the fish that we want to see more of. These are responding really well to the flow releases.
These are simple tweaks to maintain the function of the system. There's no reason for us not to do this. Caddo Lake means too much to too many people, and it means too much to too many different species for us to lose it.
I've been other places to visit, but it's just not the same. I always just keep coming back to here. It's just a special place. Within 5 minutes from the dock, you can forget what year it is, maybe what century it is. It's worth doing everything you can to leave it better than we found it. There are a lot of lakes in Texas. There's only one Caddo. It's worth saving.